Hello everyone, today we will learn proxy servers and how HTTP supports their functionality. So let us start. A proxy server, also known as a web cache, is a network device that helps speed up internet browsing by storing copies of recently accessed web pages and files. When you set up your web browser to use a proxy server or a web cache, every time you request something from the internet, your request first goes to the proxy server. If the proxy server already has a copy of what you are asking for, it sends it to you directly. This makes browsing faster because it does not need to get the file from the original website again. Let us see how it works. Suppose your web browser is set up to use proxy server and you are requesting a picture test.png from a website. The web browser set up a TCP connection to the proxy server and asks for the image test.png via HTTP request message. The proxy server checks if it already has a copy of the image. If it does, it sends the image back to the web browser via HTTP response message. If the proxy server does not have the file, it connects to the original website www.xyz.com and asks for the file. Once the proxy server gets the file from the original website, it saves a copy and sends the file to the web browser. Therefore, a proxy server acts as both a server and a client. Server is a device which provides data, and client is a device which requests data. When the proxy server gets requests from a browser and sends back responses, it functions as a server. When it sends the request to an origin server and receives responses, it acts as a client. A university might install a proxy server on its campus network and set up all campus browsers to use it. But why would a university choose to install a proxy server on their network and have all browsers use it? There are two main reasons. First, it can make web pages load faster for users. This happens when the proxy server has a copy of the requested data stored in it. There is no need to travel across the internet to get the requested data. Instead, it is provided by the proxy server. Second, proxy server helps to reduce traffic or reduces the amount of data flowing through an organization's internet connection. This means there is no need to buy costly internet connection plans, thereby reducing costs. In simple words, if you are on 15 Mbps internet connection, there is no need to buy 100 Mbps internet connection because proxy server is not forwarding all requests to the internet. To understand how proxy servers can be beneficial, let's look at an example involving two networks, an institutional network and the public internet. The institutional network is a fast 100 Mbps local area network connected to the internet by a 15 Mbps access link. The origin servers are spread across the globe. What are origin servers? They are the servers which stores the original website. The HTTP request messages from the institutional router to the internet router are negligibly small and thus create no traffic in the access link. The internet router forwards the request to the origin server and receives the requested objects in about 2 seconds, which we will refer to as internet delay. The internet router then sends these objects to the institutional router over a 15 Mbps access link. Let's assume the average object size sent to the institution router is 1 megabit, and there are 15 requests per second from the institution to the origin servers. the bandwidth of the access link is 15 Mbps. Therefore, the traffic intensity on the access link is 1. It means that the access link is operating at 100% of its capacity. This causes high delays. Once the institution router receives the object, it sends it to the destination web browser over 100 Mbps local area network. Therefore, the traffic intensity on the institution network is 0.15. It means that the local area network is operating at 15% of its capacity, resulting in minimal delays, say 10 milliseconds, which is 0.01 seconds. On the other hand, a traffic intensity of 1 on the access link means the link is fully used. As the traffic intensity gets close to 1, delays on the link increases a lot, causing the average response time for requests to take minutes, which is unacceptable for the institution's users. To reduce the average response time from minutes to seconds, the first solution is to increase the access link speed from 15 Mbps to 100 Mbps. This creates a traffic intensity of 0.15, causing minimal delays of just 10 milliseconds. As a result, the average time it takes to receive the requested object for 15 requests is 2.02 seconds. So, the first solution causes a delay of 2.02 seconds. The second option is to employ a proxy server. Normally, a proxy server fulfills between 20% to 70% of requests. In our scenario, let's assume it satisfies 40% of requests, which means 6 out of 15 requests are handled by the proxy server, while the remaining 60% or 9 out of 15 requests are forwarded to the internet router. Therefore, the traffic intensity of the access link is 0.6 and the traffic intensity on the institution network is 0.06. Traffic intensity of less than 0.8 causes less delays, say 10 milliseconds or 0.01 seconds. Therefore, the overall average delay in receiving objects for all 15 requests is 1.216 seconds. So, the second solution causes a delay of 1.216 seconds. By comparing the delays in both solutions, it's clear that a proxy server is the better option. While increasing bandwidth may be cheaper initially, installing a proxy server often proves to be more cost-effective in the long run due to lower ongoing costs. However, keep in mind that the copy of an object in the proxy server may become outdated. So, how to manage this and ensure that the stored object is always up to date? Fortunately, HTTP has a way for proxy servers to check if their stored objects are still up to date. This is called a conditional GET. Let us see how it works. When a web browser requests an object via HTTP request message, the proxy server sends the HTTP request to the origin server if it does not have the requested object. The origin server sends the HTTP response message, which contains the requested object and its last modified date. The proxy server stores both the object and its last modified date and sends the requested object to the web browser. A week later, another web browser requests the same object. The proxy server checks if the object has been modified in the origin server. It sends a conditional GET. Note that the date in the if modified since header is exactly the same as the date in the last modified header sent by the origin server a week ago. If the object has not been modified, the origin server responds 304 not modified. This tells the proxy server or a web cache that the object has not changed and it can send the stored version of the requested object to the web browser. This process saves bandwidth and reduces load times. This concludes our discussion on proxy servers or web cache. We have explored how proxy servers work, their benefits, and how they ensure the data they store remains up to date. Please share this video so that more people can learn. Thanks for watching.